you do get resolved.
Velasco sent word to Castillon. He's on his way. Let's look around first. I want to know why he's in Kirkwall. So, Castillon's looking to expand his slaving business. Why am I not surprised? The city guard will find these documents very interesting.
And Velasco told me you were all tied up. A lovely present just waiting to be opened. I see he's paid for that little mistake. What a pretty smear he makes. Well played, Isabella. Crossed and double-crossed.
You want to talk? Maybe we should talk about these documents. Slavery in the free marches? They're not going to like that.
Get to the point.
Give me your ship, and your word to leave me alone, and you can take these papers and go.
If you want the ship, can't we just kill him and take it?
You don't just kill a man and take his ship. That's crude and amateurish. How will he tell everyone how I bested him if he's dead?
Can you trust him? He trades people for money.
Castillon's a businessman, and this is a business deal. He'll keep his end of the bargain.
Why can't you surprise me in a normal way? With flowers, maybe, or a cake?
I see I wasn't the only one played today. Give me the documents. And you can have the ship. And you will never hear from me again.
Swear it.
I swear it on my mother's grave. Give me the documents.
You've made your decision, Isabella. Do as you wish.
The ship is yours. Let me say, my dear, that you would make a remarkable ally for any man able to tame you. Our business is hereby concluded. Forever. Be well, Isabella.
He didn't deserve to walk free. He'll get what's coming to him someday. Doesn't need to be at my hand.
How does it feel to have finally gotten the ship of your dreams?
Better than three greased-up sailors. I really should haul anchor first thing tomorrow morning, but I don't know. I've taken a shine to Kirkwall, and some of the people in it. I might stick around. Come on. I'm bored of this. We should do something fun.
I can't believe you're still not taking sides.
I told you, I only like to be on top.
I mean against the Templars. You like freedom, right? You hate slavery. Why wouldn't you side with the mages?
Maybe I just don't like you. I'm bored of this. We should do something fun.
Good to see you again, Miss Eyre. If you need me for anything... by all means, let me know.
You're here. Good. I wanted to talk to you.
Ah, you're still here. At least some things are constant in this ever-changing world.
What? If you call me your rock or your foundation, I'm gonna hit you. Anyway, I'm glad you're here. Saves me the trouble of having to go look for you. I wanted to thank you for everything you've done for me. I'm glad you walked in here all those years ago.
I was drawn in by the intoxicating aroma of stale piss and vomit.
Now that I have my ship, I'll need a new crew. And I'd like to have someone like you on board. Someone I can really trust, who has my back, no matter what happens.
Exploring the world and getting away from all this? I'm game.
It'll be you and me chasing that horizon. I can't think of any place I'd rather be. I'm sorry. I don't know what's come over me.
What's going through your mind?
I think I'm falling for you. Just tell me, Hawk. If I have a chance with you.
Didn't you say love wasn't for you?
I know what I said. And I know why I said it. You were right. I wasn't afraid of love. I was afraid of being loved.
I've waited years for you.
Thank you for waiting.
It was worth it.
Hold there!
Who are you?
The name's Evitz. As in Evitz Marauders. The folk you killed a few years back. Now you're going to die for what you've done.
Suicidal.
You there. Did my love send you? Will you take me to him?
I come at your father's request. You expected someone else?
Fainriel, the man of my dreams. These brutes intended to take my maidenhood. As they argued about who would go first, I fainted. Then Fainriel spoke to me in a vision and told me not to fear. When I awoke, the men had slain one another. Please take me to Fainriel. I want to thank him properly.
I'm sorry, but I have no way to locate him.
Hey, what did you do to my man? I'll kill you till you're good and dead.
I must wait a bit longer for my love. Oh, thank you for your aid. I will find my way back to Kirkwall. The walk will tire me, and we'll be reunited in my dreams. Fainriel, my love, I'm coming.
step!
Get out of here!
Innards. Traps ahead.
Stop me! I do hate traps. I'm done.
You're pathetic!
It is good to be among my people again.
Greetings, champion. That is what they call you in your city, isn't it? Did you need something? I just wanted to know how your clan was doing. We are doing quite well, considering. It is our hope that one of our sister clans will give us some of their Hala by year's end.
Taken on a heavy burden, Hawk. May the creators watch over you.
We've been here too long. Mithal protect us.
We're leaving. Whether the clan is or not is up to them.
You've returned. Is there something you need?
I don't need anything right now.
Of course.
Crafting is second to none, I assure you.
Andaranatishan, child. I pray that the path before you is a safe one.
Give us strength! Oh, this will be fun! Piece of cake! Let's do this! sound better.
Thank you.
You
his crafting is second to none, I assure you. To admire.
Is this for me? It's beautiful. Do you know what it is? I only know that it was made by the Dalish. It's Sylvanwood, rare as diamonds. You only find it in very old, very wild places. The carvings tell a story of the betrayal, the dread wolf tricking all the gods away from the world. Start at the beginning. What happened to the gods? Long ago, there were two clans of gods. The Creators looked after the people, the Forgotten Ones preyed upon us. And one god who was neither, Than Harrel, the Dread Wolf. He was kin to the Creators, and in the old days often helped them in their endless war against the Forgotten Ones. Why were they fighting? No one knows. We barely even remember all their names. Let alone who struck the first blow, who was wrong. Than Harrel was clever. He could walk among both clans of gods without fear, and both believed he was one of them. He went to each side and told them the other had forged a terrible weapon, a blade that would end the war. He told the Creators it was forged in the heavens, and the Forgotten Ones that it was hidden in the abyss. And when the gods went seeking it, he sealed them both in their realms forever. Now he alone is left in the world. I imagine the Dalish don't depict the doom of their gods just for decoration. Not exactly, no. This was made for a keeper, you see. Guarding a clan from the Dread Wolf is a keeper's place. It's a very sweet memento, thank you.
breaks of it tomorrow, maybe. Good payday.
Wards held by pretenders. Aspects. The true source is missing. The power unheld. But I command a peace.
The true source? What do you claim to have?
Fragments of every fool who held a throne. Here, or in the black. I am pride with reason. I enslave the whims and weirds, the dreams from the other side of the veil. Face me. Face everything.
Yeah! Well, we won.
One love. Don't worry
Welcome home, Brassair. Everything's quiet.
Things have been very troubling these last few years, haven't they? I was thinking that it might soon be time for my boy and I to move on.
Back to the merchant's life, I suppose?
It's an honor to serve the champion of Kirkwall. Make no mistake. But I'm getting older. It's time to see the Sandal's future. I'll stay on until arrangements are made. I hope that's all right.
If you're worried about Sandal, I can help him out.
Oh, well, that's mighty kind of you, but it's unnecessary. My boy's been offered a position in Orlais. It seems the Empress herself found one of his enchantments and is intrigued. Can you imagine? Us in the Imperial Court. Hopefully this business with the Templars doesn't get worse before we go. I worry about you, Messire. You'd almost never know little Arana was even here. So quiet.
She smells like cinnamon buns.
Even after all these years, she still refuses to go outside. Such a shame.
Your house is pretty. enchantment.
This, the life of a pirate's going to be a bit dull, isn't it?
I know. I'll have to steal myself another Canary relic.
The scary thing is, I don't know if you're joking.
Of course I'm joking. I'm not getting involved with those people again. No. This time, I'll steal the Queen of Antiva. There's no way that could go wrong.
Have you located any Canary blades?
This is what I found.
If you find more, bring them to me.
Champion of Kirkwall, your reputation precedes you. Forgive me, I should introduce myself properly. My name is Nancio Caldera Llanos. I am a noble from the beautiful country of Antiva.
Is there something I can help you with?
I've come to you in search of aid. An elven assassin I have been chasing is loose in the area. Unfortunately, he's hidden himself among the local Dalish, no doubt playing on their shared heritage. He's a master manipulator, who will endanger even his own kind to ensure his survival.
You don't seem the type to hunt assassins. Why are you after him?
At first, it was merely duty to Antiva. But after losing so many good men to him, it became personal. He's nothing but a murderer, a thief, and a liar.
Your assassin is no fool. I doubt the Dalish would hand a fellow elf over to you, murderer or no.
Ah, so you see my problem. Where that elf goes, death follows. He must be captured quickly. I've heard of your dealings with the Dalish. I was hoping you could go where my men could not. Find out where the assassin is hiding, and apprehend him.
I'll see what I can do.
One of the Dalish, a woman named Variel, is a friend of his. I suggest speaking with her first.
We won't be here when you get back. We got a campsite outside the city. Look for us there.
I shouldn't have worn these shoes.
Dalish crafting is second to none, Ash.
Greetings, champion. That is what they call you in your city, isn't it? Did you need something? I hear there is a criminal hiding among the Dalish.
He is not among us. This criminal of yours is set up in a cave away from our camp. He said there would be people looking for him, and to tell anyone who asked where he was.
Why would he give away his position?
He said he didn't want to endanger our people by asking us to lie for him. Not something you'd expect from a cruel and evil murderer, is it? He'll be waiting for you at the cave. Good luck trying to reach him, however.
Strange. Why would the assassin want the Dalish to give away his location?
But the Keeper didn't say...
Just do it. We're leaving. Whether the clan is or not is up to them.
Strange. Why would the assassin want the Dalish to give away his location?
From the look of these traps, the assassin was definitely expecting company.
Everyone stay still and try not to make any loud noises. Piece of cake.
Now you, I wasn't expecting.
I thought I smelled Antivan leather.
Isabella! If it isn't my favorite pirate wench.
Shouldn't you be dead by now?
I could say the same, my dear. It seems we were both fortunate to find powerful friends, no? How do you do? My name is Zevran Aranai, adventurer and occasional assassin.
I've heard about you. You helped the hero of Ferelden stop the Blight.
At your service, my friend. I must admit, I was waiting for an assault by the Krolls, not the mighty champion of Kirkwall.
How do you know I'm the champion?
Slayer of Qunari, Deep Roads Explorer, and a beauty to make the gods jealous? You underestimate your fame.
How do you two know each other?
How does anyone know Isabella?
Yes, well, you'll never know Isabella again if you keep that up. I'll assume you're not talking about birds.
Oh, please, do not tell me you know nothing of the Antivan Krolls. We are the finest guild of assassins, an object of fear throughout the lands for any man with wealthy enemies. Or I should say they are. I am no longer a Krolll, a fact they find unacceptable.
There must be more to it than you leaving the guild.
That is offense enough to the Krolls, believe me. I may have also killed the last four assassins they sent after me, and all their men. Oh, and the guildmaster. In fact, if you were a Krolll, you might make a fortune bringing me in. You should consider a career change. No, really.
I thought you'd be taller.
Let me guess. A man named Nuncio has asked you to capture a dangerous killer, yes? What did he say this time? That I killed his wife, butchered his parents, sold his children into slavery? Or did he tell you he was a lawman from Antiva, charged with apprehending a ridiculously handsome fugitive?
He also said you were a wanted murderer.
Oh, indeed I am. But technically, I imagine everyone here can rightfully claim that title. Bring me to Nuncio if you wish, but I warn you, he surely intends to kill you. The Krolls do not like loose ends, unlike myself. But you are a woman who can clearly handle herself, yes? Why worry? So, you can either tie me up, gag me, and then manhandle me. Or you can take me to Nuncio. Which will it be, I wonder?
You know him best. What do you think?
I've had better.
I meant about letting him go or not.
Oh, right. I'd let him go.
You're very compliant for a fugitive.
Compliant, yes, and very bendy. But truthfully, I know when I am outmatched. I would rather take my chances against the Krolls.
I'm not going to hand you over to someone who lied to me.
As a suggestion, you might wish to deal with Nuncio. If you don't, he will only come after you. It's been more than a pleasure, my dear champion. Fare you well.
You didn't tell me the assassin you wanted captured was once one of your own.
So Zevran told you, did he? It really doesn't matter. This time, his warden isn't here to protect him. I am thoroughly disappointed. No one fails the crows and lives.
Ah, poor stupid Nuncio. The crows do like that saying, but I am living proof it's a lie. Why they insist on thinking they can kill people like you and the warden, I will never guess.
Why didn't you go when you had the chance?
And risk a beauty such as yours be marred by a crow dagger? Oh, never.
You are nothing but a traitor and a coward, Zevran. You'll die here.
Yes, well, let's see how that works out for you.
Looks like...
Talk to me when you're done.
Thank you.
Excellent. Killing my former brothers in arms is oddly satisfying. I've little reward to offer you, champion, but perhaps this will serve as a token of my thanks. My dear Isabella, it has been a delight to see you again. You travel in fine company.
That's it? You're leaving? What about sex?
Still blunt as a dwarven hammer, huh? Well, why not?
I hope you haven't forgotten about me.
What? You can come too.
Indeed. The more the merrier.
Let's find someplace quieter.
Ha! That girl has curious standards.
It's still standing. Will wonders never cease?
Leave that alone. There are things in my life that don't actually involve you, you know. Stay out of my business, girl.
That note mentioned the gem of Kuroshek. What's that?
It's nothing. Never mind.
If you're worried about who sent the note, I can go in your place.
Did I ask for that? I don't know who sent it, and I don't want to. I lost everything chasing that gem. Our fortune, our home, even Mara.
Who's Mara?
She's none of your concern. That's who she is. Why don't you head back to your fancy house in Hightown and stay out of my damn business?
Thank you.
There is justice in the world.
Is there? You want to free the mages. Let's say you do, but to get there, you kill a bunch of innocent people. What about them? Don't they then deserve justice?
Yes.
And then what? Where does it end? It's like a bar brawl. People are continuously pulled into the fray, and nobody remembers why it started. Justice is an idea. It makes sense in a world of ideas, but not in our world.
You still owe me 5 sovereigns, Elf.
I'm good for it.
So you think you can win the coin from Isabella? Good luck with that. Coming to the Hanged Man for Wicked Grace later?
Never miss it.
Are you the ones who sent the note about the Gem of Kuroshe?
We were beginning to think you wouldn't show. It's rude to keep people waiting, you know? It's not like I don't got things to do.
I think you have mistaken me for someone else. I don't know you.
You don't got to know me. You just got to listen. See, we was hired to give you a note. But this Gem of Kuroshek thing the note talks about, we decided we want that instead. You better hand it over.
I was told to come here to get the gem. Why would you think I have it?
You have it. Or you can take us to whoever does. That's what I think. We aren't going anywhere without that gem. Isn't there a mallet hanging on the wall in Gamlin's house?
So who is Bianca?
My crossbow. Say hello, Bianca.
But why Bianca? You must have named her after someone.
Nope. Mirabelle was taken.
The way you fondle your weapon is disturbing.
Hey, I'm a perfect gentleman. In public.
what do you want now?
I found this note on a thug who attacked me. It mentions your wallop mallet.
Haven't played wallop since I was a kid. Still got my mallet up on the wall, though. Last time I was any good at something.
Now, you must see what an injustice the Templars are.
Must I? I see Templars trying to control what they have good reason to fear.
But they go too far.
Talk to Hawk about her mother. Ask her who went too far.
You can't hold all mages responsible for that.
It doesn't take all mages to cause this. Only the weak ones.
Let's go see if this Venadal tree can give us any answers.
Well, we found the tree the wallop mallet's made from. Now what?
Wallop mallet? You must be the one I'm supposed to give this note to.
Did someone ask you to give this to me?
I was given a few coins to hand this over to whoever came asking about wallop mallets. Unfortunately, the person was hooded, and it was dark. I didn't get a good look. Obviously a human, though. No mistaking that. Even hooded, you all look alike.
A warehouse now? We're being played with.